Last time. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to open, and I'd like to welcome you to our December business meeting. And I would like to ask Ms. Anaya to please read the Open Public Meetings Act statement.
On Thursday, January 14, 2021, notice of this meeting was mailed to the press and the Courant of Egg Harbor Township. Notice was also delivered that day to the Egg Harbor Township Clerk and posted on the bulletin board in Township Hall.
May we have roll call, please?
Ms. Alabarda?
Here.
Mrs. Bird?
Present.
Mr. Della Barca is absent. Mr. Ireland?
Here.
Mr. Price?
Here.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Here.
Mrs. Salagi?
Here.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Here.
And Mr. Castellano?
Here. If I can ask everyone to join me for the flag salute. Following the salute, we're going to have a moment of silence. Please remain standing for Alice Banta and Tina Camp, former employees who have passed. Well, again, thank you all for coming. First, we're going to approve the minutes. May I have a motion on 4.1 through 4.8, please?
So made.
Second.
Is there any discussion?
I missed the second. That was both of you. I'll give it to Ms. Alabarda as a farewell.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Alabarda?
Yes.
Mrs. Berg?
Yes.
Mr. Ireland?
Yes.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Loggy?
Yes.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Yes.
And Mr. Castellano?
Yes. Thank you. So I want to welcome everyone again. A lot is going on now. Nice crisp winter evening. Christmas is coming. However, there's a number of things happening, unfortunately, with our COVID situation. We're all hoping for the best, and that this will just be a very short blip, and we'll get back on the road to being fully recovered. We all certainly hope and pray for that. Before I turn things over to Dr. Gruccio for the report, I'll just let you know that for three of us, this evening is our last board meeting. And what we'll do is, during board member comment, each of us, I'll give everyone a chance to say a few thoughts in parting. So we'll do that at that time, if that's okay with everyone, and then we'll allow all board members to comment after that during our board member comment. So with that, I'll turn it to Dr. Gruccio for our superintendent's report.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Castellano. Welcome to our December meeting. And here's our superintendent's report to give you an idea of what's going on in the school district that's centered around our district learning goals. Maybe not. Here we go. Okay, just a quick COVID-19 update. As you know, we held our vaccination clinic at Miller School. That was for the second vaccine on December 6th. Testing is continuing for our faculty and staff through Rover Labs. That is the company that comes into our school district and conducts the testing, and that's held on Wednesdays. Our district pandemic team, met last Wednesday, and topics were discussed. They revisited what we do, they reviewed, they talked about, and they recommended. The district doctor, Dr. Petrucci, joined us, and basically the recommendation was, because we are seeing such a high number of cases, as you can see, our cases here, 104 staff, 337 students, and in the past 14 days, we've seen 85 cases. you have folks out on quarantine, staff and students. So his recommendation, since the county is at an orange level right now, to continue with what we are doing. So in January, over break, we'll be looking at desk shields that need to be replaced or better cleaned, so that when we come back in January, they'll be in place. However, in January, we will have a discussion again. Hopefully the cases start going down and we can start preparing for removing desk shields. There's also a test and stay pilot that was approved and will be occurring in some school districts. I'm not sure if we're gonna be one of those school districts as of right now, because that just occurred today. But I will tell you a little bit about it, and that's basically where students and staff would test if they're a part of a contact tracing and would have to quarantine, where you see we have staff and students who are in quarantine, so that they would go get a test, and if they were negative, they wouldn't have to quarantine. So that's something that's being piloted in schools right now, or soon, starting in January. Egg Harbor Township Safety and Security. I briefly mentioned this. I went into pretty much detail at our last board meeting about Egg Harbor Township Safety and Security. So as you know, we are monitoring social media. We're responding to anything that we feel potentially could affect our schools. We're responding to the Department of Education and their recommendations regarding inappropriate behaviors. But I do want you to be reminded that we work very well with the Egg Harbor Township Police Department. We've partnered with them. They've had a presence in our schools, outside of our schools. We also have, in the last 4 or 5 years, put a security department in place here that we've never had before. We have 3 Class 3 officers. We have a security team of armed guards, unarmed guards. We work well with our administration, who are always out and about, listening to students, listening to parents, seeing things, addressing things, and as well as our high school and K through 12 guidance departments and our child study team services. As you know, over the last couple of years, we've improved our vestibules. There were construction projects that were put in place to make our entrances more secure. We vet our visitors. Our guards are in place at all the entrances. Our staff's been through ALICE training. Our crisis teams have been trained, and protocol is known throughout the district. We also have radios and phones for our staff to use. So I just want to assure you that we have these particulars in place. Okay, regarding student achievement, great things that have happened over the last month in the school district. We have STREAM activities at Fernwood, where the students are building roller coasters. Our book fairs are back in action, first time in a year and a half. Just a reminder, parent conferences will be in January, 10th, 11th, 12th, and 13th. Our advanced placement class up in the high school has studied the Industrial Revolution, and they have some great projects that they shared with the high school school community. And high school early acceptances. This is very impressive. Their students, senior students at the high school, have been accepted to the University of Pennsylvania, University of Pennsylvania's Wharton School of Business, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and Brown University. Such early acceptance, so that's pretty impressive. Also, regarding student achievement, in our Fine Performing Arts Department, we had our students in the All South Jersey Band, All South Jersey Choir, and our middle school students as well in the All South Jersey Orchestra. So we have students listed here from wind ensemble, clarinet, to horns, violins. So again, our talented is being recognized above and beyond our school district. So congratulations to these students for their efforts, once for their interest, for their talents, and then pursuing a challenge here and accomplishing great things. Under climate and culture, great winter concerts have occurred over the last 2 weeks. It's amazing. They were great to hear, and some of the talent that the students were introduced to, not only singing, but dancing and percussion opportunities. Our schools also had pajamas and dress-up days to celebrate the holidays. Renaissance sponsored door decorating contests throughout the district. Cultural traditions were celebrated throughout the district. Spirit Week occurred in schools. And our guidance department have been doing lessons with the students regarding coping, helping them with coping skills, HIV, which is bullying, harassment, anger, and academics. So we are getting in the schools and working with our students to improve the climate of the buildings. Regarding community partnerships, the Village Grand gift cards, these gentlemen are very determined to assist our school district, and we appreciate that, and we will be honoring them at our January meeting. But $13,505 raised for our students at Eagle, Swiss Wave Ball Complex, and Davenport, and they generously delivered them the other day so that administration can hand it out to the students. So we were very grateful and thankful for their effort. Also, grateful and thankful for the efforts of the Egg Harbor Township Police Department, who on a whim, when I pick up the phone and talk to the chief and say, yeah, I need a presence, they're right there to support us in our schools and outside of our schools. And again, to show a partnership that they care about the health, safety, welfare of our students and staff. Also, New Jersey Police did a presentation to the students at Fernwood regarding the dangers of social media. Community partnerships with the food bank. Our students participate in a lot of donations, collections for donations for food. Kingpin Alley hosted our high school adapted phys ed class, and they went on their bowling trip, and it was a great opportunity for the students to take part in a bowling lesson in a bowling alley, and they had a good time. If you'd like to learn more, you go on the high school s'mores, you'll get to see the pictures of the students in action. Egg Harbor Township alumni. We had some students, former students, come in and speak to our English language learners classes, and they shared about life outside of Egg Harbor Township and beyond graduation with the students. So it was a great experience for them. Toy collections took place throughout the district, and Egg Harbor Township alumni Eagle Eye newsletter is alive and kicking. So if you're interested in participating as an alumnus, feel free to check out the newsletter and share your story with us. And you're always welcome to come in, just like the former students did, to talk to our classes and share and educate students. Just wanted to post these community partnerships because we're very grateful that we have them. And some of you may not know of some of the resources that are available in the school district, and some that have reached out to our students and have assisted our parents in dealing with some of the situations regarding social and emotional issues. So we're very, very thankful for those community partners. Just want to put another notice up to let you know that our substitute pay has increased, but it also, the structure has changed. So if you're interested, you could see on our website. But it lets you all know that Kelly Services would gladly accept your registration to assist us in our schools. Okay, so Mr. Castellano, if you would like to join me. As Mr. Castellano stated, we have some departing board members this evening, him being one, but right now he's going to serve in the capacity of president and assist me with recognizing board members who have volunteered their time, given their a lot of hours for the students of Egg Harbor Township, passing policy, discussing situations, approving personnel. So there's a lot to the position, just wanted to make sure we showed how grateful we are, and we appreciate your service. And I'll let you begin with Mrs. Alabarda.
Okay, so we're going to bid farewell first to Ms. Terry Alabarda, who has served us so well and on more than one occasion has stepped up to the plate as we've asked her to fill in and fill on expired terms, and just done an outstanding job. Every time she hits the ground running, she does her homework. She's an ideal board member. She's a teacher, she's a mom, and she's a consummate professional. I can't say enough thank yous and express my appreciation for you. Now I'll ask Mrs. Christy Bird to come forward. Again, now Christy served a full term with us, was elected, and served a full 3-year term. Just, you know, I'm gonna hand this to you, and I'm gonna just repeat some of the same things, you know, that I said with regard to Miss Alabarta, someone who comes here every week, prepared, eager, contributing, passionate, again, a mom, a parent, an educator, just such an outstanding background to bring to the board. And just as Miss Alabarta has, you've made a tremendous difference. We thank you very much for your service. We hope to see both of you back someday.
Okay, now you get to pass the mic over and recognize Mr. Peter Castellano. Champion. That was then and this is now. He still has it. We got to witness it a couple hours ago out in the commons area. Appreciate your talent as well. But Mr. Castellano, I present it to you with greatest appreciation for dedicated service to the children Egg Harbor Township Schools. His service is 2001 to 2021. So that's quite impressive. Out of all the hours, probably thousands and thousands. So we wish you the best in your new journey. May your Tuesday nights never be the same. And good luck to you, and we're going to miss you. Appreciate your support. Thank you. Just need to share our visual. Somewhere. Okay, enjoy. a whole lot to be proud of. So thank you for the applause. Thank you, Tyler, for all that you do for us each and every month with collecting all the good things that are going on in our school district. But again, I like to highlight all the things that are going on in case you're, you know, not aware of them. It's so important to appreciate what we have here in Egg Harbor Township School District. And thank you, Board of Education, for your support and for allowing for those things happen. I think you saw the Unified Sports is up and running. And I had a parent come up to me over the weekend and say, thank you so much. My son is so overjoyed and excited to finally be a part of something. So thank you. We got that off the ground and running, and it's already making a difference. So thanks again. Thank you. That concludes my report.
Thank you very much, Dr. Guccio. Great report. Thank you for honoring me and, of course, Ms. Alabarda and Mrs. Bird, two outstanding board members who I'm going to miss very much, and we'll hear from them just a little bit later. And at this time, I have the very high honor of presenting our student rep. We haven't heard from one of our reps in a little while, and it's just great to see one of our students out with us.
Thank you for the introduction. Madeline couldn't make it tonight. She has a mock trial meeting. So firstly, all of our winter sports have started this week or last week, and we are excited to see how their seasons go. At the high school, as Dr. Guccio said, 30 students went on a field trip to Kingpin Bowling, and it was an extension of their adapted physical education lesson. On December 15th, Ms. McGowan had some EHTHS alumni come in and talk to her ELL students about what life after graduation is all about. Last week, many high school students auditioned for All South Jersey Band and All South Jersey Choir. Congratulations to all of those musical students. Last week's Student of the Week at the high school are Joshua Hackett and Marilee Palomino. As always, these students were selected by their teachers. Honors Biology students did an interactive lesson last week, and they made origami models of cell membranes and learned about various cell transport mechanisms. Last Wednesday, Alder Avenue Middle School Choir performed, and the students gave an outstanding live performance under the direction of Mrs. Weatherby. Fernwood Middle School is having a Winter Spirit Week, just like many of our other schools, and students are encouraged to wear different themed apparel each day of this week. Lastly, Alder staff and students have been collecting donations for families in need this holiday season.
Well said. Thank you very much. Thank you. Please take our best wishes back to school. Wish everyone happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year from the board and administration. Okay, with that, we're going to move to our first comment period on agenda items. If anyone has comments on items that are on the agenda, now would be the time if you want to come forward.
Hello. Kathy Wazin.
Just touch the base for the microphone.
Okay, there you go. Mr. Castellano, this is, I think, an agenda item. Your retirement after 20 years of serving on the Board of Education, your dedication goes without saying, your commitment to the Egg Harbor Township School District and the children that come here, as well as the parents, is bar none. You have dedicated many, many years. You have gone to Trenton. You have fought in Trenton for us. You have gone to committee meetings and fought for our school district. You have done a lot of things that a lot of people don't know that you did, because you did it silently and you plugged away. You got us the money that we were denied quietly again. But there are people that noticed these little things that you were doing along the line. And those people appreciate the support that you have given them throughout the years, because we are a team in Egg Harbor Township, and this team has to work together. And when the team doesn't work together, things fall apart. And because of your dedication and commitment, you have kept the team together and you have kept this district running along with the help of the administration. So the association, and I as the president of the association, appreciates that, and we would like to give you this plaque in honor of your marvelous 20 years of service. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Pete. Enjoy your retirement.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Wazen. That really means a lot, and your words were very touching. I'm very, very, very much appreciated. It's been a labor of love for me, and yeah, I'll talk a bit about it later, and just thank you again. Okay.
Can I speak?
Oh, sure.
Is this still open for?
Sure. Agenda items, yes, please.
Yeah, so I am mostly
curious.
Excuse me,
if you could just please give your name and address, if
you
don't mind.
Thank you so much. I am Sarah Haney. I live at 99 Deer Path Drive in EHT. I have I know these two over here. I've got a third grader at Slaybaugh and a fourth grader at Miller. I'm curious how we came to the determination to have virtual conferences this year. I see that we're having activities in all the schools, and...
Okay, so normally this first comment period's for agenda items.
Right.
But we'll go ahead if we can sort of just sum up.
Virtual parent conferences, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yes, well, this was a discussion over the summer that we had with our principals, mm-hmm. and the feedback that they received was that there was overwhelming response with the virtual conferences, and it worked with mm-hmm. for parents very well, that they were able to juggle their homes in terms of children and dinner and all mm-hmm. that, and be able to tune in, and it was a one-on-one with the teacher that worked well. So that was decided in the beginning of the school year, and Mrs. Moss, you could comment any more, because I know you some more if you have anything more than what I just said, but I know that we met, and I know you're working with the principals and have had discussions with teachers regarding the success of the virtual conferences.
I think that Dr. Bruccio summed it up well, but it was a discussion of, allowing the turnout to be really more successful with the virtual for parents who might not have been able to attend in the past, childcare, other responsibilities. You could take 15 minutes at work and sign in. So it's really just, it was a success last year, and as a parent, you're always entitled to request meetings or to call a teacher. So, but this was for the parent-teacher conferences agreed upon.
Yeah, and as a parent, I have requested in-person meetings, and I've been told to come straight to the source by both principals that I spoke with and the teachers that I spoke with. I have an issue because I am new to the district, and I have two children in the district, and I have never set foot aside from a holiday concert last week with 150 parents and 75 children, shoulder to shoulder. And I don't understand why I can't sit in the classroom with my child's teacher alone for 15 minutes.
Okay, so we appreciate that very much. We generally don't do a question and answer, back and forth. We limit comments to 3 minutes. We do appreciate your comment. What I'm going to suggest is that we set up an appointment for you to come in and speak with Dr. Gruccio about this, one-on-one, and see what we can work out for you.
Do you have my contact number? Or I could give you my...
Sure.
card.
I also have her contact information.
I left a message in your office, but I'll...
Which one?
You did?
Yeah.
A couple last week.
If it's not readily available, Dr. Gruccio, we did get her information. We can pass to you tomorrow.
You have my phone number?
You're in our student database. We All found right. you. We found you.
Thank you.
Sorry, joyful levity.
Okay, so moving on from the agenda item comment period, we're going to move into finance and operations. I'm going to ask for a motion on 8.1 transfers, please.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Roll call, please.
Ms. Alabardo?
Yes.
Mrs. Bird? Mrs. Bird? Actions 8.1 transfers.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you. Mr. Ireland?
Yes.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Salagi?
Yes.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Yes.
And Mr. Castellano?
Yes. can I have a motion now on items 8.2 through 8.17, please?
Motion.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Ms. Alabardo?
Yes.
Mrs. Bird?
Yes.
Mr. Ireland?
Yes.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Salagi?
Yes.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Yes.
Mr. Castellano?
Yes. Okay, thank you. Moving into curriculum, we have one item, field trips and state 9.1. May I have a motion, please?
So made.
Any discussion?
I missed the second. I'm sorry, was it?
Carried.
Ms. Alabardo, thank you.
Any discussion? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Ms. Alabardo?
Yes.
Mrs. Bird?
Yes.
Mr. Ireland?
Yes.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Salagi?
Yes.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Yes.
And Mr. Castellano?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, now we're moving in into this next section will be just a collection of a couple items that were not on last month's agenda. We did take a lot of action last month, as I said, because there are a number of things that needed to be in place for when we come back from break. There's a second reading on a number of policies. They're fairly straightforward, but I'll ask for a motion and then I'll see if there's any discussion just in case there may be questions on any of those items. So I'd like to ask for a motion on 10.1 through 10.6, please.
So made.
Second. Is there any?
Second.
Got it. Is there any discussion on those items? Okay, seeing none, can we have roll call, please?
Ms. Alabardo?
Yes.
Mrs. Bird?
Yes.
Mr. Ireland?
Yes.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Salagi?
Yes.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Yes.
And Mr. Castellano?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, old business, HIB, I'm gonna ask Mrs. Hauk-Elko to read the motion, please.
Sure, I would ask the board to entertain a motion to affirm the HIB determinations SSC 01, DAV 01, JDM 02, JDM 03, A 02, A 03, A 04, HS 03, as discussed in executive session.
Thank you. May I have a motion?
Motion.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Seeing none, roll call, please.
Ms. Alabardo?
Yes.
Mrs. Bird?
Yes.
Mr. Ireland?
Yes.
Mr. Price?
Yes.
Mrs. Sullivan?
Yes.
Mrs. Salagi?
No.
Mrs. Gilbert Floyd?
Yes.
Mr. Castellano?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, the only thing I have this evening on communications is I believe that the reorganization is Tuesday, January 4.
Yes.
Is that the correct date? So just to make that announcement for everyone to mark your calendars, enter that into your phone. At this point, we're going to move into our second public comment period, which can be on any topic. And we just ask that you give your name and address for the record. And we limit comments to 3 minutes. And I'm not sure if we have, if we've heard, or if anyone has any public. Now would be the time. Please come on forward. Okay, seeing none, we're going to go ahead and move to board member comments, and I am going to take the privilege of going first. To sum up, I'm not going to try to sum up 20 years, but I just have a couple of brief thoughts. I want to say what an honor and a privilege that it has been to serve the students and the people of Egg Harbor Township for these past 20 years. I worked very hard and I truly tried to make a difference. So I want to first thank the people of Egg Harbor Township for putting their trust in me and for casting their votes for me all of these years, through these past 20 years. I want to thank my family, my wife Sue, my daughter Beth Ann, and my daughter Christine. Without their support, I couldn't have been here and done this. It was just crucial. There's no way to explain it. I could not have put the hours in from a time standpoint and emotionally to have been here without the support from home. And I think all of us up here know, without that support from home, it's just not possible. I want to thank all my fellow board members who are here, board members past as well. Being a board member is a volunteer job, and in a district this large, it's a very, very big volunteer job that takes up a lot of time. And especially when you take on extra and added activities, before you know it, you're out many, many evenings, you're out on Saturdays, Sundays, and there's just a lot to it. So I want to thank all the board members, past and present. And then really, I want to just sort of do what I've tried to do all this year, is just thank everyone in the district for the outstanding job that everyone has done through the years, but especially these last few, through these difficult times, which I pray are almost over. I want to start with the outstanding members of our administration, all of them: Dr. Gruccio, Ms. Anaya, Mr. Santilli, Ms. Moss, Dr. Charlton, Ms. Shoemaker, Mrs. Shoemaker, all of our staff. I couldn't possibly name some and not others. I'd miss some. All the staff members that contribute to allowing us to serve the students in so many ways. All of the staff members, and of course, our teachers, our paraprofessionals. You are all simply the best. You know that I mean that. Everyone knows me very well. You know, I'm a pretty straightforward person, and you know that I mean that. And thank you so much, Mrs. Wazin, for recognizing me this evening on behalf of them and for being here. It's very much appreciated. You are all the staff, everyone, you are all simply the best, and I thank you. With that, I will turn it over to whichever of our other two departing board members who'd like to say a few words. Who'd ever like to go first, Mrs. Bird or Miss Alabarda?
Okay. I first want to acknowledge Pete. 20 years. I don't know how you've done it. 3 years, my one term. Feels like it's been 20 years. So I think that I applaud you because, like Ms. Wazin said, you've done so much for our district and made so many positive impacts in a lot of places that and didn't necessarily take credit for it. So very well done, and I learned a lot from you over these last 3 years. So congratulations, and thank you for all you've done for my children and for this district. When I decided to run for board myself, it was kind of a spur of the moment thing. I didn't even tell my husband. All of a sudden, I made an announcement, hey, I'm running for board. That's how I roll up my house a little bit. But when I ran, I said that I would ask a lot of questions. I would ask for data. I would do my homework. I would not be political. And I feel that I can honestly say I've done all of those things. I wear my heart on my sleeve. I have done that up here. Everything I've voted for and everything I've said has been in the service of children. I will continue to advocate for our district just in a different way from here on out. When I decided not to run for a second term, it was a very difficult decision, but quite honestly, I think that over this term, especially during the pandemic, I put the needs of 7,400 students in front of my own children in some ways. And so it's time for me to put my own kids and my family first. So it's been a great honor, and I'm thankful for the opportunity to serve the district. And I wish everyone good luck and work together and put politics aside because they don't matter and they're not real. Do what's best for kids. If when you're up here and you're asking questions and you're asking for data, it's not doubting anyone. It's just asking for more information. But put kids first. If you can say to yourself with every vote, is it right for kids? Then you have nothing to worry about, and there is nothing someone can write about you on social media that you ever have to lose sleep for. Is it right for kids? Then you did your job up here, and you advocated for your community in a positive way. So I wish you all the best, good luck, and thank you, EHT, for trusting me.
Thank you, Mrs. Byrd. You have been an outstanding board member. Ms. Alaborda.
Hi. I wanted to thank, first of all, the board for trusting me and appointing me to fill in for the position. I really enjoy it. This is really how I like to volunteer. I feel that it's my strong suit, as I've been in education for 20 years, and I have a lot of education behind me. It has been my pleasure to be here every Tuesday, or almost every Tuesday, volunteering in this capacity, and I've really enjoyed it. Really, if there's anything I can do, I'm not so far away, I'll just be on the other side. So just let me know what I can do. And I just want to remind everyone, basically the same as Christy did, is that our students need to be at the forefront. If we don't embrace them, if we don't worry about their mental health, if we do not take care of their needs, they're not gonna learn. There's a lot going on right now, and we need to make sure that every decision is right for kids. And we're putting adults in front of our kids that are prepared to deal with them. And I know this as a parent. You know, I have three children in the school district. I also want to thank all of the staff of Egg Harbor Township. As an educator, I understand how difficult it has been the last year and a half, 2 years. We have done things that we have never had to do before in an instant. We have to fill in. You know, as educators, that's what we do because our number one concern is the children. So I just want to thank everyone who works in Egg Harbor Township. And I will not be far away, so you guys know where to find me.
Thank you, Ms. Alabarta. And just as I said of Mrs. Bird, you have been an outstanding board member. And I hope we see you both back up here again someday, Mrs. Bird and Mrs. Alabarta. Now, the next person I'm going to recognize thinks I forgot about her, but I have not. And I have a special thank you for Mrs. Amy Elko, our trusted advisor and counselor. But she is much more. She's truly a team member in this district, and her service to us has been absolutely invaluable, and it's much appreciated.
Thank you very much. And I have to say, I'm very sorry to see all three of you go, and I wish you all the best.
With that, I will see if there are any other board members who have comments. Any other board members? Mr. Price and then Mrs. Slaggy.
Okay. Gee, I don't know where to start. I mean, it's just incredible how time flies, and it's been a pleasure working with all three of you, Terry, Pete, Christy. It's been an honor to serve with you, and it's just a world of experience that we all had to offer, working together and learning along the way, and I'm proud to have served with all of you, and I think that we've made the best decisions for the children. It's a lot that goes into being a board member, as you said, and I just can't thank you enough, all three of you, for your service. And like I said, it was an honor to serve with you, and looking forward to serving with you again maybe someday in the future. So stay involved, and we'll be here, and we want to continue to see you come out to the meetings. And we'll miss you. So that's all I wanted to say. Thank you again for your service.
Thank you, Mr. Price. Mrs. Slaggy is next.
Yes, this meeting at the end of the year is always a little sentimental and sad, and moving on to new things. And it has been a pleasure working with all three of you. Thank you for your service, because I know how much it's taken from your life with your family. I look forward to working with our new members and being a team for the students of Egg Harbor Township.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Slaggy. Any other board members? Anything else? Mrs. Gilbert Floyd.
I know you're surprised. And I want to say Pete instead of Mr. Castellano. So, we all know that I am Mr. Castellano's favorite board member, so just so the rest of y'all know, I'm his favorite. At least I told him I was. So, you know, with Mr. Castellano, it's funny to me because the first time I met him was in that room in there. It was 2005. And matter of fact, Mr. Castellano and Mr. Loggy were in that room. They were all sitting there as a board education, and I came walking in for an interview. And they gave me their vote, so I appreciate that. I wouldn't have, you know, been here in Egg Harbor Township. So that was my first time meeting Mr. Castellano, was at an interview. So, and things change in life. And when I came and ran for the board, to have the opportunity to see what you did, what you do on this side with the board was amazing, and to see how a school, when you work in a school, you see what you do in a school, but when you work with the Board of Education, it really shows you the ins and outs of how a school is ran and all the work that goes into it. So one thing I will miss about Mr. Castellano is his dad jokes, which I thought, you know, I guess they're mom jokes too, because I do the jokes at work. Sometimes I'll take some of his jokes and use them at work, and people look at me strange. But we think they're funny, and we appreciate all your jokes, Mr. Castellano. And one thing I would say, Mr. Castellano has been the same. His personality, and we have similar personalities. Jokingly, I'm just saying, we do. We love kids. and we love EHT. And I'm just really proud to serve with you. And I think you did an amazing job, and to do it for 20 years is outstanding. And it says a lot about you and your passion for EHT and just our school district and our community. So thank you so much. And Christy, is it right for kids? I think that's, she should get that tattooed on her neck. Because that is, she'll fight me, you, anyone, when it comes to children, and especially when it comes to them learning how to read. And I admire her passion and her fire and her boldness. She feels that she's gonna say it. If she believes in it, she's gonna fight for it. So I definitely admire that about you. Doesn't always win popularity contests, but that's not what we're here for. Mrs. Alabarda, who graduated with the world's greatest class of 1993 from Egg Harbor Township High School, I always say that, but I believe that EHT students always come to the forefront because we've had a great education from our teachers and from our, you know, within our community. So it's been great serving with you as well. That's all.
Thank you so much, Ms. Gilbert Floyd. It's very much appreciated. Any other board members? Administration? Anyone? Any final thoughts? Yeah. Dr. Yes. Gruccio, yes.
Yes, yes. Couple things. First, best wishes to our departing members. Again, thank you for your service and your commitment. We appreciate the work that you've done, but more so your insight and your perspective that you brought to the board and to administration to make us better at what we do, right? So the better informed we are, the better that we know what's going on, the better that we can serve. So appreciate that. Mr. Castellano, thank you for your service as a leader. It was nice working with you and preparing for board meetings and being proactive as we all need to be as leaders. So I'll be cautious of my words here. So I'm going to say out with the not so new and in with the new. Present this evening, we have our new board members in the audience. And thank you for attending. So with you here, I'm able to share that on January 4th, and I think you know that because my staff has met with each and every one of you, will be reorganization for the 2022 Board of Education as we embark on new leadership and new board members to care and support for our students. So that night on January 4th will be reorganization. New board members will be sworn in to office that evening. What I want to share is after reorganization, it's like, okay, now what? Now what is what I propose that on January 11th that we hold a retreat, and that retreat will assist the sitting board members to get to know, build relationships with the new members, and to become one unified team to serve, which is very important. And we'll go over some of the items. I always say boardmanship 101 and address some of the needs and explain some of the things that we do so we can get off a good start. Also on that night, to be able to discuss our meeting structures and how the meetings will flow so that Chandra, as board secretary, can send out a board calendar to the public. So that's what I propose. I wish you all a very happy, peaceful, restful winter break and holidays, and celebrate with your family and friends what you celebrate, but be sure to enjoy and really, really take that time to just take a deep breath and spend some time first with yourself and then with those that you love. So with that, I say happy holidays again, and everyone have a great night. And thank you, student rep, for coming out tonight.
With that, I'm going to wish everyone a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy New Year, good luck to the new board, and may I have a motion?
Second.
By acclamation, we are adjourned for 2021.